Hello, welcome Adab, welcome to Motoroids. My name is Kamran and today's vlog is going to be a very specific product review of a long-term usage of the Maxxis Rally tires. If you've seen our last video regarding the same, we evaluated a few options. We went into the technicalities. If you want to see that video, you'll find the link down in the description. About this, what we are going to do today is we've used these tires fitted on our Xpulse 200 here. We've ridden around 3,000 to 3,500 kilometers, both on and off-road. And today we are going to speak about five things we really loved about these tires and two things which we did not. So let's start with the thing we love the best on these tires are the broad separated knobbies on it. These knobbies are self-cleaning. As you can see, there is enough gap in between these two tires, which makes self-cleaning of the knobs very easy. Now, self-cleaning really helps you when you are in a slushy, muddy condition, as well as when you are riding in a terrain which has a lot of big stones which can get stuck into your knobbies and make the traction impossible when you are riding hard on the terrain which is rough and full of dirt. The second thing we loved about these tires are the tall side knobs. The side knobs are not perpendicular to the tire. They are slightly tilted on both the sides, as well as they don't run continuously on the circumference. They give you enough split between the two knobs, which help you gain traction, as well as if you're going hot into a corner, it also allows you to have a controlled slide and come fast out of it. As you can see right here in the video, which what we are doing is the same. We are coming hot, we are allowing the tire to lose traction for a while, but we trust the side knobs to catch that and help us slide through really fast and exit the corner hard. The third thing which we loved about these tires is the carcass. What we loved about the carcass is we've tried these tires at a tire pressure which are less than 15 and this behaved perfectly well. There was no pinch flat. I've tried it in slushy conditions where going low on tire pressure is really important, and these tires stood the test of it. The fourth thing that we really loved about these tires is the tire compound. While Maxxis says it is a soft to intermediate terrain tires, I've used it on hard surface. I'm sure a lot of people who will be using these tires in the Indian road condition are going to somewhere or the other use it on a very hard terrain surface, and these tires have stood the test. They give you enough confidence on the dirt and the mud while allowing you to ride it confidently on the tarmac as well. Now, this is very important for us because not all of us can afford to load their bikes in a truck and send it to the track every single day. So the best thing to do is ride those 50-60 kilometers up to the track or the trail you're going through. And these tires have proven themselves on the road. Make sure you don't ride your motorcycle on the roads quite often because these are not road legal tires. And in fact, we would suggest you not to use them on road at all. So as I said, these tires are soft to intermediate terrain tires, which means you can ride it in the dirt as well as on quite intermediate surface like hard pack rock. I've used it on wet rocks, climbing steep slopes, and they have done pretty good. I've also pitched these tires against different other brand of tires which are available in the market right now, both in the same price range and slightly lower. These tires, I was very happy to say that performed excellently well. And I was not just content, I was really happy and surprised to see that they really stood well. Because when we read their soft to intermediate terrain tires, I was kind of in double mind if I'll be able to use it on tarmac or I'll be able to use it in the really hard surface like rocks and stones. But I did use it. I took a chance. And these tires proved themselves pretty well there. So last but not the least is the availability of these tires. They are a direct fit to the Xpulse motorcycle. And I'm sure a lot of motorcycles into the off-road segment use the 2118 setup. And this is a boon because we are able to get these tires anywhere in the country from any Hero Service Center, as well as if you have a Maxxis dealership near you, you'll be able to get these tires pretty easily. Now let's discuss the two things which we did not like about these tires. Now both these things which I'm going to say might disturb a few of our viewers, because the first point specifically is the wrong usage of this vehicle. I'm using this vehicle for both on-road and off-road purpose, and that has really deteriorated the mileage which I was supposed to get on these tires. Currently, as I said, I've used it just over 3,000 kilometers, and both on and off-road, I probably 1500 kilometers each, or 50-50 share, and the first 1000 kilometers out of this was purely on an off-road surface. that time the bike worked fantastically. There was almost very little to nil wear on the tires. But post that, I started using this bike for my daily commute, which was not much. So the problem which I started facing there was low traction. One is low traction, and the second is the part of the same problem which I'm going to say now, is the amount of miles which you're going to get on these tires. If you notice, these tires have really worn out in 3,500 kilometers because 50% of that I've used it on the road. And if you use it purely off-road, my assumption as per my experience is you might be able to squeeze out around 6,000 to 7,000 kilometers out of this. But if you're going to use it on the tarmac, say you're going to use it purely on the tarmac, you are lucky if you're able to squeeze out even 3,000 to 3,500 kilometers in it. Now, the second con which we are going to speak about these tires can be taken both ways. It can be taken positively as well as negatively. And the complaint which I have with Maxxis is the pricing of the tires. There are knobby tires in the same 2118 setup which you'll be able to get at almost one third the pricing. We bought this tire 6 months back when it was priced just over 10,000, and right now the price have gone up to around 14,000 rupees for a set. Why I feel that this topic is debatable is because a lot of time when these international manufacturers come to the Indian subcontinent, they try to match up the prices of the existing product in the country or deteriorate the product to make it slightly cheaper. Whereas in this case, Maxxis has gone up a notch. They are providing us with the best they have. These tires are proven across the globe, as well as the Hero factory team are using these tires in all the INRC rally across the country. The Maxxis MaxCross tires are one of the most proven products at the Maxxis lineup and one of the flagship. And we are glad that we've got the opportunity to use the Maxxis flagship tires instead of any cheap replacement or substandard product. So if you're paying that few grands extra, is for the extreme high quality and durability, as well as the confidence they're going to give you on the off-road and the dirt section while you are racing, rallying, or just enjoying your weekends. So to sum up today's video, I'd like to say, if you're someone who's got an affordable X-Pulse 200 motorcycle who wants to learn off-roading, these are the tires to go for. They'll give you immense confidence off the road. They'll help you enhance the skills because you might want to push slightly harder. But believe me, spending those extra few bucks is really worth it on these tires. The major drawback is wrong usage. If you're going to use these tires on road or on surface, it's not meant to be. They're going to wear out pretty quickly. In our case, the amount of wear and tear I've got on the bike right now is because of the wrong use of the tires. These tires are meant for rally, these tires are meant for racing, these tires are meant for off-road. If you're going to use it wrongly, they're not going to last. In fact, you might just end up getting very little mileage on these tires, and it's not worth spending that amount every 3 months. So if you're getting these tires, make sure, make up your mind and use these tires where they are meant to be. And the place where they are meant to be performing, they perform extremely well. I'm really happy with my choice. And I am sure with the amount of videos and footages you've seen today, you've realized how much confidence enduring these tires are. We've tried to cover the pros and cons of these tires to the best of our capacity, but I'm sure you guys would still have doubts. The off-road community in India is growing. The adventure segment community in India is growing. A lot of people are looking for different options available in the market. Maxxis is one of them, and it's, as per me, with my experience, it's one of the finest. But if you have any more doubts and queries regarding these tires or anything else in the similar segment, please drop into the comment section. I'll personally try to revert to all of you individually. In the meanwhile, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon. We are going to do a lot more of such product reviews, as well as a lot more automobile content is going to come on this channel. Stay tuned for more. And once again, any doubts and queries, comment section down below. I'll be reverting to you personally. My name is Kamran, and I'm signing off.